Okay. Iowa State. This was an interesting one. We both had this as like a game to watch, and we've professed our love for Matt Campbell on this podcast. Last week I also did one of my locks of the week was Iowa. They were plus 3.5, I believe. And while I won that because they won the game by 10, it does kind of feel like I was on the wrong side of it because it does. I do think Iowa State pretty much outplayed them for the most part, but turnovers are the great equalizer. And props to Iowa. They did not turn the ball over nearly as much as Iowa State. And yeah, that's all it takes sometimes. So Iowa gets yet another win against Iowa State. For me, I do think that this is leading up to Iowa State probably now being undervalued and Iowa being overvalued. Iowa is like 127th in the country in yards per play on offense. But they have two impressive wins. They do have two impressive wins, blowing out Indiana and now beating Iowa State by 10. Do you have other takeaways from this? Am I being too down on Iowa here? Should we just give them total props for beating a good top 10 team?
Not total props. No,
Okay.
okay. It's the same thing with the Indiana game. I don't know how they handled Iowa State. Iowa State got a late touchdown to make it close, but that was a 17-point game late into the fourth quarter. They handled Indiana. How are they winning these games? Okay, like if I'd read you the stat lines, you would say there's no chance they're winning. Their best rusher had 21 carries for 55 yards and one touchdown. Spencer Petras, who he's okay. He's 11 of 21 for 106 and a touchdown. How are they like? I don't understand how they're winning. They're probably going to be a top five team, I think. And actually, in the AP poll, they are now. I believe that came out. They are a top five team now. It is official. Dear God, they're going to get absolutely embarrassed when they play someone that like. I love Matt Campbell. Again, we're a Matt Campbell podcast. We've professed our love for him. How you lose to that team, that's a bad loss. I think there's no other way to put it than that's a very bad loss. I understand Iowa does the fundamentals very well. I understand that. They have great offensive line play, great defensive line play. I get it. They're opportunistic on defense and they create turnovers and they convert those into points. I understand. They have no one to threat you on that can really hurt you on offense. Nobody. How are you giving up 27 points to a team that does not look at all threatening on offense? It blows my mind. And no, I don't, are they the best team in the Big Ten? Are they the second best team in the Big Ten? No one knows. Like, they're a team that you could either see, they could either fake it all the way up into like a New Year's Six Bowl and then get blown out, or they could just get like blown out by Ohio State, you know, and like it would just be like a 40-point just a drubbing, you know. You could see either one happening. So no, I don't know. They won and in just the most unimpressive way possible. They're in the top five. Yay. Like, I don't care. Like, 'cause I still don't think they're that good. I picked them to be really good. I picked them to win their division and to go and play for the conference championship. They will, apparently. They're probably going to do that. I was just disappointed. I don't know. The offense is really bad, and that's what I have to say about it.
Yeah, it does seem like every year there's a team or two that just has like two or three more wins than they should based on turnover luck. And it does, and last year Indiana was one of those teams, and I probably overvalued them in the offseason just thinking that, hey, like this is such a fun team and Tom Allen is such a great coach. And I think some of that is true. And then, you know, the turnover luck goes the other way. Sometimes that's usually what it happens. Turnovers are not predictive from year to year. They're highly erratic, even from game to game. So maybe fade Iowa would be a good principle from here on out. Just to see, I don't know. Keep your eyes on Iowa lines going forward. But yeah, props to them. They're 2-0. They've beaten two ranked teams and they have an incredible defense. So that's not nothing for sure. Like that's something. And in the Big Ten West, that might get you pretty far.